This result is expanded for a set of matrices to share common diagonal solution. Now, this set A has a common diagonal solution if and only if. Now, we have M matrices, so we choose M positive semi-definite matrix here. Not all of them zero. For this arbitrary matrices, positive semi-definite matrices, the summation AK XK has a positive diagonal entry. If this is the case, we have that this set, in the matrices in this set, has a common diagonal solution. Now, we work on another characterization for diagonal stability, which is due to Krejci-Wenger. Now, A being diagonal stability is equivalent to A Hadamard product S, this circle is Hadamard product, I will define now, is a P matrix for all positive semi-definite with diagonal entries all being 1. Now, Hadamard product is defined as the entry-wise product of two matrices. So what is P matrix? A matrix is called a P matrix if all it is the principal submatrices has positive determinant, which means principal minus sub positive. And third condition is the improvement of the second one. A has positive diagonal entries. This is the first condition. We need to check that. And determinant of A Hadamard product S is greater than 0 for all such positive semi-definite matrices. The advantage of this result comparing to the previous characterization, now, first we are using Hadamard product comparing to regular matrix multiplication, and the number of operations is like less than the regular matrix multiplication. And the other one is we have a restriction on the set of positive semi-definite matrices. We now deal with only the such S with diagonal entries all being 1. Our goal is here, can we extend this result, similar to the other extension, to a set of matrices share a common diagonal solution. Now here, that the P matrix condition here also to do this extension we need to extend the P matrices here, so we start with this and try to extend P matrices. Now P matrix has a characterization. A real matrix is P matrix if and only for any non-zero vector x, real vector x, xi times axi is greater than 0. The xi is the ith entry of the x. Now we use this characterization to extend P matrices to a set of matrices, like we call this as P set. We are given real matrices A1 through AM, and we call this set as a P set. Now for any xk, we choose m real vector, not all of them zero again. Now there exists some index I, the summation of xik times ak xki is greater than zero. So if this summation is greater than zero, we get the p-set condition. We also characterize the p-sets. Now this is similar to the result of the characterization of common diagonal solution. Now, A being P set is equivalent to, for any xk, the real vector, with m real vector, not all of them zero, the summation of ak times xk, xk transpose is a positive diagonal entry. In the shortened Berman and Goldberg's result for the characterization of simultaneous diagonal stability, we multiply AK by any positive semi-definite matrix. Here, we only multiply this by rank 1 positive semi-definite matrices. So that means this is a necessary condition for A having a common diagonal solution. So we use this also in our main theorem. Now this is the main theorem one, and this partially extend the Frege-Wengers result. Now we have set of matrices A1 to AM. A has a common diagonal solution. This is equivalent to A1 Hadamard product S1 to AM Hadamard product SN. This set has a common diagonal solution for all SK with all diagonal entries being 1. And this, the third condition set says that this set is also a P set for all such SKs again. Now, outline of the proof is, like, the proof is a bit longer, but let me give the outline here. One implies two is, this follows from the observation of any positive diagonal solution of AK in the set A. This is also the solution for AK Hadamard product SK. So this is the observation, because this follows from the result. SK has the all diagonal entries, just one, and it is positive semi-definite. If you take the Hadamard product of such matrices with any positive definite matrix, we get again a positive definite matrix. And we know that AKD plus DAK is positive definite, because D is a solution, diagonal solution for AK. 2 implies 3 because P set property is a necessary condition for simultaneous diagonal stability or common diagonal solution. 3 implies 1. This based on the idea here, we choose any XK. And we try to write this XK as a multiplication of the matrices DK, SK, and DK. Now, XK is any positive semi-definite matrix. Here, SK is the positive semi-definite matrix with all diagonal entries are equal to 1, which is the matrix we use in the third condition. And DK is diagonal matrix with diagonal entries are equal to square root of diagonal entries XK. Now here, by using the characterization of P set, we just now first choose vectors YKs. Now each YK is here. The entries of YKs is equal to the diagonal entries of the matrix T. Now here is the idea. Now the third condition says it's we have a p-set condition for these matrices. Now from the characterization we know that if we multiply the matrices in the set with any rank 1 positive semi-definite matrix, which means here yk transpose is one of the matrix here. If we multiply these two matrices and we get the summation of all of them, we get a positive diagonal entry. So left hand side follows from the assumption and the characterization. Now actually we are looking for right hand side. Now we need to prove that A has a common diagonal solution. That means summation of AK times XK is summation of AK XK has a positive diagonal entry. Now there are intermediate result between, but basically we just show that these two matrices have same diagonal entries. So left hand side has a positive diagonal entry from the assumption, so that means right hand side also has a positive diagonal entry, and this completes the proof. Now P set condition is actually a strong condition, and also it's theoretic now, and we are looking for some explicit conditions here. And we try to find a relation between P set and P matrices, because we know that P matrices are like the definition from definition. We know that P matrices are equal to all principal submatrices have positive determinant. Now this condition is here: we have a matrix, we have a set of matrices A, and this is PSAT, if and only if summation AK Hadamard product YK by K transpose is a P matrix for any YK. So, but YK has a, sorry, has a condition that for any index I, YK is non-zero for some vector YK. So, by using this connection, we prove, we extend our main theorem here to give some definitive determinative conditions. Now, A having a common diagonal solution is equivalent to summation of AK Hadamard SK is P matrix. SK has a condition here. There are positive semi-definite matrices. For any index I, there exists a SK that diagonal entry at this position I is equal to 1. And third condition is improvement of the second one. So for diagonal solution, we only need to check that all diagonal entries of the matrices are positive. And also, determinant of the summation AK Hadamard SK is positive number. So SK is here again the same type of matrices we use in condition. So condition two. So this is the full extension of the Kreijer-Wenger's result to the common diagonal solution case. In the last part, I would like to present our another work on alpha stability. This is the extension of regular types of matrix stability here. Now, we consider a partition alpha of the set N. And this alpha 1 through alpha p, this union of these matrices gives us the set N, where alpha k's are mutually exclusive and non-empty. And we just say that if p is equal to 1, that means we only have one set in alpha. We simply write alpha is equal to set N. Now, two notions we use to define the extensions. One of them is alpha diagonal type matrices. A block diagonal matrix with diagonal block indexed by alpha 1 through alpha p is set to alpha diagonal, which is, I give an example here. Now, A is equal to this matrices A1 through AP. These are block type matrices, block matrices. These are A is a block diagonal matrix with A1 through AP. That means rest of the entries are zero, except the A1 through AP. And the each matrix AK here has the order, the cardinality of the set alpha K. And the other type, the other notion is alpha scalar matrices. This is a diagonal matrix. And for any, the alpha K, for any, for partition alpha, the alpha K is a scalar multiple of the identity matrix of the same size. Here, D is equal to C1 times I1, C2 times I2, and to Cp times Ip. Here, I1 through Ip are the identity matrices with the order, the cardinality of the set alpha K. Now, Hershkowitz and Messel extended these notions to H alpha stability. If H alpha stability is defined as A times H is stable matrix for any positive definite alpha diagonal matrix H. Now, in part, this is extension of destability, which means destability is A times any positive diagonal matrix is stable. Now, here we deal with the alpha diagonal matrices. And in the strongest case is, if alpha is the set N, then HN stability is called the H stability. And in this case, we are multiplying A by any positive definite matrix. Another extension on diagonal stability. Now, Lyapunov alpha scalar stable, they use the term Lyapunov alpha scalar stable. And if there exists a positive definite alpha scalar matrix P, AD plus DA transpose positive definite, then we call this as Lyapunov alpha scalar stable. And if this is AD plus DA transpose is positive semi-definite, then we call this as alpha scalar, reopen of alpha scalar sinus theorem. And in our work, we used an alpha stability for this kind of matrix stability. And when alpha is equal to just set n, we use the S stability notion here. Now, we work on another type of matrix stability to extend similar to Hershkovitz and Meschel's result. This matrix type is additive destability. That means A being additive destability is stable under addition of any non-negative diagonal matrix D. Additive destability arises in diffusion model of biological systems, and after linearization at equilibrium, after linearization, it guarantees the asymptotic stability of the equilibrium. And also, there are some other applications in other areas like mathematical economics and mathematical ecology. Now, the main problem here. By the way, do I have time, Dr. Cherry? Like, maybe 5 minutes more.
Maybe 10 to 5.
Okay. Yeah. So, the main problem here for additive destability, it's open that there is no characterization. So, we work on this problem, but we obtain a sufficient condition, and this is actually a good progress for this problem, because it is still open that there is no characterization for this type of matrix stability. Now, that means this condition is, if A is a stable matrix and it is an L alpha semi-stable for some partition alpha, then this gives us the additive destability. L alpha semi-stability is defined here. For any alpha scalar D, AD, DA transpose is a positive semi-definite matrix. But for any, for some partition alpha, if we have L alpha semi-stability condition, this works for the additive destability. This is not a necessary condition. We also showed that by a counter example, it's not a necessary condition. This one is sufficient. We extend this result to additive H alpha stability here. Now, this is defined as A plus H, where H is any positive semi-definite alpha diagonal matrix H. If this matrix A plus H is stable, then we say matrix A is an additive H alpha stable. Now, when alpha is just singletons, then additive H alpha stability is additive D stable. And we use additive H stability in place of HN stability here. This new notion, additive H alpha stability, can be interpreted as the asymptotic stability of the following equilibrium of the following general diffusion problem. Here, in the summation, Hij arises, and these are the entries of the matrix H. And this, if the H has an alpha diagonal structure, then additive H alpha stability arises. And one of the applications that can be used in the diffusion problems. And one other extension we introduce here, on a P0 matrices. P0 matrix are the A being P0 matrix is equal to all principal minors are non-negative. And this is a characterization for this type of matrices. That means for any non-zero x, there exists an index I such that xi is not zero, and xi times xi is greater than or equal to zero. Now, we extend this result for non-singular matrices because in the P0 matrix result that mostly given for the non-singular matrices, for the characterization are mostly depends on the non-singularity of A, so that's why we just extend this type of matrices by using non-singularity. Now, a non-singular matrix A is set to P0 alpha if there exists a partition alpha k, like the set alpha k, sorry, the partition that Ax alpha k is not zero, and x alpha k transpose Ax alpha k is greater than or equal to zero. Now x beta here, like x alpha k, of course, is a subvector of x indexed by alpha k. So when alpha is singleton, a p0 alpha matrix is actually a non-singular p0 matrix. And when alpha is set n, then p0 alpha matrix is a non-singular positive semi-definite, but not necessarily symmetric matrix. So this notion unifies the such general positive semi-definite matrices and the non-singular p0 matrices. Our main result can be just summarized here. Left side is the known result for regular types of matrix stability. This is the relation, and we extend this relation to alpha stability case. So A being alpha stability implies A being FFH alpha stability, and this implies A being P0 alpha matrix. And this gives us an equality, like the phenomenal condition that A plus H is non-singular for any alpha diagonal H positive semi-definite. So this is the extension of the result given in regular matrix stability. But also our result contains this known result as a particular case. We also study on the particular case of the alpha stability, which is the strongest condition. Now here, A being H stable implies A being H stable. A being H stable means A plus any positive semi-definite matrix is stable. Now this is equivalent to A being stable and A plus BB transpose is not singular for any real vector B. So this is a very interesting result, because now H stability is like a stability under addition, but A plus BB transpose is a non-singularity condition here. And another characterization for this result is A is stable and A plus A transpose is positive semi-definite matrix. Maybe just I should skip this part. We also propose two conjectures here. The fully characterization of non-singular P0 matrix is A plus D is non-singular for any non-negative diagonal matrix D, and this is also equal to A is non-singular and A plus D is non-singular for any positive diagonal matrix D. We propose a conjecture for the full extension of this result, and we prove the first two conditions are equivalent, but 2 implies 3 is also is immediate, but 3 implies 1, so it's still open, and we prove this conjecture for some particular cases also. And another conjecture is we propose here the alpha gear partition. If A is an H alpha stable matrix, then A is a P0 alpha matrix. We prove this conjecture for particular case, like for some particular alpha. And I think I'm just skip this part. And just briefly, I discuss about the future works we have. Diagonal stability, like the are the explicit algebraic conditions for diagonal stability is proven for only 2x2 and 3x3 case. So can we obtain for higher order cases, like the characterization depends only on the matrix entries? So the for matrices order higher than 3 is still open, so we are looking for also working on this problem. An extension of simultaneous diagonal stability problem to the simultaneous L alpha stability case. This is our ongoing work, and there are some open problems also in the alpha stability case, which is the characterization of H alpha stability and additive H alpha stability, and also stability properties of structured matrices. Structured matrices means that the matrix with the entries are formulated, there is a formulation for the matrix entries. So this is the one of the structured matrix, sync matrix, which is S plus 1 over EE transpose. E is a vector of all ones, and S is the structure matrix here, which all entries are the integral, the SK is integral 0 to k sin x, which this function is in pi x over pi x. And this is skew symmetric and topless matrix. This used in the numerical solution of the partial differential equation on the convolution problems that, like this method described by Stenger, Frank Stenger. And recently this matrix, like the solution of this problem depends on the stability condition of this matrix I inverse. And we know that it's stable, it's already proved by Dr. Han and Dr. Xu. But we don't know that this stability. So this is a problem in this area. And we computation verified for some cases, but in general it is still not known if it is a destable matrix or not. Destability is that means a matrix is stable under the multiplication of any positive diagonal matrix. These are the references that we use, and I try to present here the our works with John Ferb with Dr. Xu, and thank you. Simply, this result is extended for a set of matrices to share common diagonal solution. Now, this set A has a common diagonal solution if and only if. Now, we have M matrices, so we choose M positive semi-definite matrix here. Not all of them zero. For arbitrary, for this arbitrary matrices, positive semi-definite matrices, the summation AK XK has a positive diagonal entry. If this is the case, we have that this set, in the matrices in this set has a common diagonal solution. Now we work on another characterization for diagonal stability, which is due to Krejci-Wenger. Now, A being diagonal stability is equivalent to A Hadamard product S, this circle is Hadamard product, I will define now, is a P matrix for all positive semi-definite with diagonal entries all being 1. Now, Hadamard product is defined as the entry-wise product of two matrices. So, what is P matrix? A matrix is called a P matrix if all it is the principal submatrices has positive determinant, which means principal minus sub positive. And third condition is the improvement of the second one. A has positive diagonal entries. This is the first condition. We need to check that. And determinant of A Hadamard product S is greater than 0 for all such positive semi-definite matrices. The advantage of this result comparing to the previous characterization, now first we are using Hadamard product comparing to regular matrix multiplication, and the number of operations is like less than the regular matrix multiplication, and the other one is we have a restriction on the set of positive semi-definite matrices. We now deal with only the such S with diagonal entries all being 1. Our goal is here, can we extend this result, similar to the other extension, to a set of matrices share a common diagonal solution. Now here, that the P matrix condition here also to do this extension we need to extend the P matrices here, so we start with this and try to extend P matrices. Now P matrix has a characterization. A real matrix is P matrix if and only for any non-zero vector x, real vector x, xi times axi is greater than 0. The xi is the ith entry of the x. Now we use this characterization to extend P matrices to a set of matrices, like we call this as P set. We are given real matrices A1 through AM, and we call this set as a P set. Now for any xk, we choose m real vector. not all of them zero again. Now there exists some index I. The summation of xik times ak xki is greater than zero. So if this summation is greater than zero, we get the p-set condition. We also characterize the p-sets. Now, this is similar to the result of the characterization of common diagonal solution. Now, A being p-set is equivalent to, for any xk, the real vector, with m real vector, not all of them zero, the summation of ak times xk, xk transpose is a positive diagonal entry. In the shortened Berman and Goldberg's result, for the characterization of simultaneous diagonal stability, we multiply AK by any positive semi-definite matrix. Here, we only multiply this by rank 1 positive semi-definite matrices. So that means this is a necessary condition for A having a common diagonal solution. So we use this also in our main theorem. Now this is the main theorem one, and this partially extend the Prejean-Wenger's result. Now we have set of matrices A1 through AM. A has a common diagonal solution. This is equivalent to A1 Hadamard product S1 through AM Hadamard product SN. This set has a common diagonal solution for all SK with all diagonal entries being 1. And this, the third condition set says that this set is also a p-set for all such SKs again. Now, outline of the proof is, like, the proof is a bit longer, but let me give the outline here. 1 implies 2 is, this follows from the observation of any positive diagonal solution of AK. In the set A, this is also the solution for AK Hadamard product SK. So this is the observation, because this follows from the result. SK has the all diagonal entries, just 1, and it is positive semi-definite. If you take the Hadamard product of such matrices with any positive definite matrix, we get again a positive definite matrix. And we know that AKD plus DAK is positive definite, because D is a solution, diagonal solution for AK. 2 implies 3 because p-set property is a necessary condition for simultaneous diagonal stability or common diagonal solution. 3 implies 1. This based on the idea here, we choose any xk. And we try to write this xk is a multiplication of the matrices DK, SK, and DK. Now, XK is any positive semi-definite matrix. Here, DK is, SK is diagonal, the positive semi-definite matrix with all diagonal entries are equal to 1, which is the matrix we use in the third condition. And DK is diagonal matrix with diagonal entries are equal to square root of diagonal entries xk. Now here, by using the characterization of p-set, we just now first choose vectors yk's. Now each yk is here, the entries of yk's is equal to the diagonal entries of the matrix T. Now, here is the idea. Now, the third condition says it's we have a p-set condition for these matrices. Now, from the characterization, we know that if we multiply the matrices in the set with any rank 1 positive semi-definite matrix, which means here yk, yk transpose is one of the matrix here. If we multiply these two matrices, and we get the summation of all of them, we get a positive diagonal entry. So left-hand side, the follows from the assumption and the characterization. Now, actually, we are looking for right-hand side. Now, we need to prove that A has a common diagonal solution. That means summation of AK times XK is summation of AK XK has a diagonal, positive diagonal entry. Now, there are intermediate results between that. Basically, we just show that these two matrices have same diagonal entries. So left-hand side has a positive diagonal entry from the assumption. So that means right-hand side also has a positive diagonal entry. And this completes the proof. Now, PSET condition is actually a strong condition. And also, it's theoretic now. And we are looking for some explicit conditions here. And we try to find a relation between PSET and P matrices. Because we know that P matrices are, like the definition from definition, we know that P matrices are equal to all principal submatrices have positive determinant. Now, this condition is here. We have a matrix, we have a set of matrices A, and this is P set. If and only if summation AK Hadamard product YK, YK transpose is a P matrix for any YK. So, but YK has a, has a condition that for any index I, YK is non-zero for some vector YK. So, by using this connection, we prove we extend our main theorem here to give some definitive determinantal conditions. Now, A having a common diagonal solution is equivalent to summation of AK Hadamard SK is P matrix. SK has a condition here. There are positive semi-definite matrices. For any index I, there exists a SK that diagonal entry at this position I is equal to 1. And third condition is improvement of the second one. So for diagonal solution, we only need to check that all diagonal entries of the matrices are positive. And also, the determinant of the summation AK Hadamard SK is positive number. So SK is here again the same type of matrices we use in condition. Condition two. So this is the full extension of the Krejcik-Wenger's result to the common diagonal solution case. In the last part, I would like to present our another work on alpha stability. This is the extension of regular types of metric stability here. Now, we consider a partition alpha of the set N. And this alpha 1 through alpha p, this union of these matrices gives us the set N, where alpha k's are mutually exclusive and non-empty. And we just say that if p is equal to 1, that means we only have one set in alpha. We simply write alpha is equal to set N. Now, two notions we use to define the extensions. One of them is alpha diagonal type matrices. A block diagonal matrix with diagonal block indexed by alpha 1 through alpha p is set to alpha diagonal, which is, I give an example here. Now, A is equal to this matrices A1 through AP. These are block type matrices, block matrices. These are A is a block diagonal matrix with A1 through AP. That means rest of the entries are zero, except the A1 through AP. And the, each matrix AK here has the order, the cardinality of the set alpha K. And the other type, the other notion is alpha scalar matrices. This is a diagonal matrix. And for any, the alpha K, for any, for partition alpha, the alpha k is a scalar multiple of the identity matrix of the same size. Here d is equal to c1 times i1, c2 times i2, and to cp times ip. Here the i1 through ip are the identity matrices. with the order the cardinality set, the cardinality of the set alpha. Okay. Now, Hershkovitz and Messel extended these notions to H alpha stability. If the H alpha stability is defined as A times H is stable matrix for any positive definite alpha diagonal matrix H. Now, in fact, this is extension of D stability, which means D stability is A times any positive diagonal matrix is stable. Now, here we deal with the alpha diagonal matrices, and in the strongest case is if alpha is the set N, then HN stability is called the H stability. And in this case, we are multiplying A by any positive definite matrix. Another extension on diagonal stability. Now, Lyapunov alpha scalar stable, it's been used the term Lyapunov alpha scalar stable. And if there exists a positive definite alpha scalar matrix P, that's AD plus DA transpose positive definite, then we call this as Lyapunov alpha scalar stable. And if this is AD plus DA transpose is positive semi-definite, then we call this as alpha scalar, Lyapunov alpha scalar semi-stable. And in our work, we used an alpha stability for this kind of matrix stability. And when alpha is equal to just set N, we use the S stability notion here. Now, we work on another type of matrix stability to extend similar to Hershkovitz and Messel's result. This matrix type is additive destability. That means A being additive destability is stable under addition of any non-negative diagonal matrix D. Additive destability arises in diffusion model of biological systems, and after linearization at equilibrium, after linearization, it guarantees the asymptotic stability of the equilibrium. And also, there are some other applications in other areas like mathematical economics and mathematical ecology. Now, the main problem here. By the way, do I have time? Dr. Cherry, maybe 5 minutes more.
Maybe 10 to 5. Oh,
okay. Yeah. So, the main problem here for additive destability, it's open that there is no characterization. So, we work on this problem, but we obtain a sufficient condition, and this is actually a good progress for this problem, because it is still open that there is no characterization for this type of matrix stability. Now, that means this condition is, if A is a stable matrix and it is an L alpha semi-stable for some partition alpha, then this gives us the additive destability. L alpha semi-stability is defined here for any alpha scalar D, AD, DA transpose is positive semi-definite matrix. But for any for some partition alpha, if we have L alpha semi-stability condition, this works for the additive destability. This is not a necessary condition. We also showed that by a counter example, this is not a necessary condition. This one is sufficient. We extend this result to additive H alpha stability here. Now this is defined as A plus H, where H is any positive semi-definite alpha diagonal matrix H. If this matrix A plus H is stable, then we say this matrix A is an additive H alpha stable. Now, when alpha is just singletons, then additive H alpha stability is additive D stable. And we use additive H stability in place of HN stability here. This new notion, additive H alpha stability, can be interpreted as the asymptotic stability of the following equilibrium of the following general diffusion problem. Here, in the summation, Hij arises, and these are the entries of the matrix H. And this, if additive, like the H has an alpha diagonal structure, then and if H alpha stability arises. And this, this is like one of the applications that can be used in the diffusion problems. And one other extension we introduced here, the P0, on a P0 matrices. P0 matrix are the A being P0 matrix is equal to all principal minors are non-negative. And this is the characterization for this type of matrices. That means for any non-zero x, there exists an index I such that xi is not zero, and xi times that xi is greater than or equal to zero. Now we extend this result for non-singular matrices because in the P0 matrix result that mostly given by for the non-singular matrices, for the characterization are mostly depends on the non-singular of A, so that's why we just just extend this type of matrices by using non-singularity. Now, a non-singular matrix A is set to P0 alpha if there exists a like the partition alpha k, like the set alpha k, sorry, the partition that Ax alpha k is not zero and x alpha k transpose Ax alpha k is greater than or equal to zero. Now, x beta here, like x alpha k, of course, is a sub vector of x indexed by alpha k. So when alpha is singleton, a P0 alpha matrix is actually a non-singular P0 matrix. And when alpha is set n, then P0 alpha matrix is a non-singular positive semi-definite, but not necessarily symmetric matrix. So this notion unifies the such general positive semi-definite matrices and the non-singular P0 matrices. Our main result can be just summarized here. Left side is the known result for regular types of matrix stability. This is the relation, and we extend this relation to alpha stability case. So A being alpha stability implies A being A H alpha stability, and this implies A being P0 alpha matrix. And this gives us an equality, like the phenomenon condition that A plus H is non-singular for any alpha diagonal H positive semi-definite. So this is the extension of the result given in regular matrix stability. But also our result contains this known result as a particular case. We also study on the particular case of the alpha stability, which is the strongest condition. Now here, A being H stable implies A being H stable. A being H stable means A plus any positive semi-definite matrix is stable. Now this is equivalent to A being stable and A plus BB transpose is not singular for any real vector B. So this is a very interesting result because now H stability is like a stability under addition, but A plus BB transpose is a non-singularity condition here. And another characterization for this result is A is stable and A plus A transpose is positive semi-definite matrix. Maybe just I should skip this part. We also propose two conjectures here. The fully characterization of non-singular P0 matrix is A plus D is non-singular for any non-negative diagonal matrix D, and this is also equal to A is non-singular and A plus D is non-singular for any positive diagonal matrix D. We propose a conjecture for the full extension of this result, and we prove the first two conditions are equivalent. But 2 implies 3 is also is immediate, but 3 implies 1, so it's still open. And we prove this conjecture for some particular cases also. And another conjecture is we propose here the alpha here partition. If A is an H alpha stable matrix, then A is a P0 alpha matrix. We prove this conjecture for particular case, like for some particular alpha. And I think and this Kirkus report, and just briefly I discuss about the future works we have. Diagonal stability, like the for explicit algebraic conditions for diagonal stability is proven for only 2x2 and 3x3 case. So can we obtain for higher order cases like the characterization depends only on the matrix entries? So the for matrices order higher than 3 is still open, so we are looking for also working on this problem. An extension of simultaneous diagonal stability problem to the simultaneous L alpha stability case. This is our ongoing work. And there are some open problems also in the alpha stability case, which is the characterization of H alpha stability and additive H alpha stability. And also stability properties of structured matrices. Structured matrices means that the matrix with the entries are formulated. There is a formulation for the matrix entries. So this is the one of the structured matrices, sync matrix, which is S plus 1 over EE transpose. E is a vector of all ones, and S is the structured matrix here, which all entries are the integral, the SK is integral 0 to K sync X, which this function is sync pi X over pi X. And this is skew symmetric and topless matrix. This used in the numerical solution of the partial differential equation on the convolution problems that, like this method described by Stenger, Frank Stenger. And recently this matrix, like the solution of this problem depends on the stability condition of this matrix I inverse. And we know that it's stable, it's already proved by Dr. Han and Dr. Xu. But we don't know that this stability. So this is a problem in this area. And we computation verified for some cases, but in general, it is still not known if it is a destable matrix or not. Destability is that means a matrix is stable under the multiplication of any positive diagonal matrix. These are the references that we use, and I try to present here the our works with joint work with Dr. Xu, and thank you.